guys, we are going to do some more bath bombs. Today we're going to use Caribbean Escape fragrance oil, and we're going to try to do three different colors, yellow, pink, and blue. I've already sipped in my stuff once. I'm going to sip it again. This is my baking soda and citric acid. Feels like it needs to be sifted again. Because of the humidity. Oh, come on. I'll tell you what, I'll come back and sift it off camera so you don't have to wait through that. But I'm going to mix my SLSA. Probably 1.5 scoops because I've got a lot more mix this time. One deal of it's clay and cornstarch. Like three different clays and cornstarch. That is my Epsom salt. I don't want to sift that. Then one thing of oats, colloidal oatmeal. Let's do it. Okay, we are back. I've got everything mixed. And I don't know if I said it or not, but the powder that started off in here was baking soda and citric acid. I've already had measured out. Okay, now we're going to put our fragrance oil in. Sweet almond oil. And don't ask me for measurements because I don't even know what they are. I just know by the look and feel of the batter. Witch hazel and 91% alcohol. This is the best way, rubbing your hands together, to get everything fully incorporated. Get this all mixed up because it's going to take a few minutes to get it all mixed in good, and then I'll bring you guys back. All I'm going to do is just mix what I just put in. Guys, I'm back. I'll tell you, I'm not very confident in this batch of bath bombs because it must be humid in here because it's just not cooperating. I can't speak. I've got yellow. Got some blue. I don't really want it too dark. Too much in there. And just a little bit of red because that's going to be pink. Okay. I'm going to turn this on, so watch your ears. It's going to get loud. I'm honest, but only I will know that. Okay. They're not... just not coming together. Maybe it'll work. Let's pray. Okay. I need another bowl. Actually, well, this mixing will be just fine because it. Because I just want it to be tropical, so if I accidentally make green, that's fine. Your embeds. Overthinking it. In there. Too much in there, it's not going to close all the way. Humidity. Damn it. Crap. Excuse my language. I'm feeling. It's not gonna work with me today. Oh, it's gonna be so pretty though. Okay, I didn't want the colors to mix that much. Ooh, it's gonna be a rainbow. Work with you guys, please. It's not going to, you know, have any moisture in it. It does, but it doesn't. Stupid weather. Come on. It worked out beautifully the other day because the weather was different. Tap it, it just... Paint's gonna turn purple. That's okay. Okay. Let's try this again. See, I wanted this a more pale blue, so the embeds, you could really see the embeds when they came out blue. The big difference, but oh well. Only I will know I messed up. I think I might like the first one turned out better. More rainbowish, like unicorn poop. Well, the pink didn't even come out. You can barely see. Oh, that's not good. Damn it. Yeah, that's weather. Yesterday, my bath, or 2 days ago, my bath bombed for this pot. That's Oklahoma weather for you. Damn it. Well, I did say I like the first mix better. I'll be back. I'm gonna get see if it's working. Okay. Here's that one I just messed up. I just put it together and we're back. I like the colors like that, though. I really do. I don't know how the embeds are going to show up, if they're going to show up. I just think it's better. Likely. Oh well. I have a feeling this is not going to be a good batch. These are for Christmas presents. Oops. I have learned that when you have a difficult batch like this that I do cup it a little bit and just very, very slight pressure. Very slight. It helps it usually stick together a little bit better. But when the weather is perfect outside, I don't have to do that. Pressure in there, but I am a little bit pushing in there just slightly. And I do mound them up pretty good. You have to get them to compact real good when you push it together. You're gonna have a lot of fallout, like that's all the fallout just by this bit. Most of it's from this backbone. Oh crap, I just messed it up. Do one more. I'm afraid I'm going to make this video too long. I still can't edit it because I'm on an iPad. Plus I have a hot process soap going in the background. I've got to check on that before I burn it. The reason why I only put in bits on one side of the bath bomb, because I find that they spin better when they're off balance like that. Oh, my back is hurting. Oh, it is stupid weather. Thank you. guys, I hope you enjoyed this.